Hello guys, you're welcome back to Niger News and Entertainment. I'll be bringing to you gist from the Ultimate Love Pad. Yeah, four confraternities in the love pad. Confraternities now exist in the isolated house where the contestants of the Ultimate Love reality show Ultimate Love reside, called Love Pad. The contestants called Love Guests are on a mission of finding a life partner, and according to their host, Auntie, they are meant to live in love with their co-housemates, even in a while coping with the tension of the contest. The relationship between the Love Guests, which began as a thoroughly blended mix of love and unity, has unfortunately turned the other way, with different factions of confraternity springing up. Many of the Love Guests have now found a group that fits into their plight, reactions, and mindset. Due to discussion that came up after discussions and outpouring of venom from Love Guests, most of them now have their peace identifying with some couples than the other. Let's take a look at the different confraternity present in the house, their members, and possible reasons they have come to be. Number 1, Presh David, Ayakrisa, and Jekesh. This seems to be the most populated confraternity in the love pad for now, with Presh Tucker, David Wilson, Ike, Teresa, Jay, and Kechi as members of this group. You should expect a lot of things to happen there. The question is, what brought about these guys together? What is responsible for these love guests sticking together by pitching their tent so firmly? What are the relationships with other love guests like? Presh David, for instance, had issues with most of the love guests from the beginning of their relationship. The genesis of the problem came from David Wilson's relationship with Rosie and the transition to Presh Tucker. You recall how almost everybody in the love pad clapped down on him when he chose Presh Tucker over Rosie, despite their public display of affection, including a passionate kiss. The kissing aspect of the scenario was the highlight of a lot of love guests, including Jay, who was a leading condemning voice. Rosie did not take this lightly, but needed to continue her life after finding love with Kachin. David became an automatic enemy for Kachin, Ebite and Obichukwu, who did not only hate his betrayal for Rosie, but because she is their very good friend. Though David Wilson might not appear to be a full-fledged enemy for Obichukwu and Chris, the new things might not be more than just being co-love guests between them and him. So when Presh Tucker got into the scene, she applied the formula, "the enemy of my friend is my enemy," to the situation. This explained the reason Presh David might not be expected in the camps of some of the couples in the love pack. He also knows this after stressing that he is seen as the black sheep of the show. Kachi embarked on a reconciliation mission in a bid to strengthen things up between himself, Rosie, David, and Presh Tucker, but it is clear that the battle is not over despite that. Ayakrisa is a couple that has not been able to hide their feelings to a lot of couples in the love part, especially to Chris. You remember the rumble between Ike, Teresa, Chris, and how it ended. The age difference between Chris and this couple did not save her from the fireworks she got when she crossed their path. Normally, it seems to have returned, but they even drew a borderline between them, and the three of them may not be ready to cross it anytime soon. So if you did not see Chris' name in this confraternity, the reason might not be far from this. Jekesh is the third member of this confraternity. Jay and Kechi have shown that they are on this show to mind their business and are too mature for bitterness or side talk. But their new attachment with Ayakrisa and Presh David has revealed their alignment, just like a Nigerian musician Faust sang about joining gangs. Jay and Kechi might have joined this gang either consciously or otherwise. The discussion going on in the group will explain to you their aims and objective, as well as give you an idea of the name they may like to provide to their confraternity. Okay, the second confraternity in the love part is Roxy and Obichukwu group. For Roxy, Kachi, Obichukwu and Ebiteyin might be the first established confraternity in the love part. Their friendship has weathered different storms and might be more potent than we see. They ensure they support themselves, stick together, support each other's relationship, and give advice when necessary. If you cross the path of one, you cross the path of all. Before the love guest pick partner, Rosie and Ebiteyin had several talks on how to go about it. Rosie advised Ebiteyin on how to be strong and building self-esteem. For Obichukwu and Kachi, the love between their women glued them together, and they are somehow enjoying the ride. The third confraternity, Roxy and Bola. There could be more to this confraternity than we know. There are different sides to the story. This is another confraternity that will be of interest to you, and the personalities involved will interest you. For Rosy and Bola, who are the ladies in this group, they are not in the good books of so many love guests in the love part. The ladies have been tagged different names like assistant, auntie, mommy, landlady, to the annoyance of other housemates. According to the love guest, Rosie is being hated for the way she behaves like mothers to them all, and how she gets strict with them sometimes. Statement like "nobody is nobody's mother here, we are all love guests" have been told when reacting to her activities in the love part. For Bola, even her partner not complains about the way she interferes in people's issues and spread information around the love guest. She has received several knocks for her apropos business, with the viewers complaining about it. It got serious to the point that auntie sent her a message from home cautioning her on some of the habits she has exhibited. So for Arnold and Kachi, having their women in the black book of other love guests, this might be the common factor that has brought them together. The name for this particular group will be funny if it comes to naming each group. The last group in the love part is Double Chris and Chivia. These couples are kind of the neutral ones in the love part. They have no particular enemy or favorite couple in the love part. Chris has said it several that she is not ready to be engaged in any side talk or gossip with anyone, stressing that she is on the show to find love. According to her, the ladies in the love part are complaining that she has withdrawn from them. Chrisville is a very sharp and jovial guy. He plays with everyone and keeps himself lively as much as possible. If you're ready to play, you might find Chrisville available in your camp. He and Chris have severally reiterated that they will never be found on the gossip web. The same goes for Chidibangs and Sylvia. They are game with everyone, nothing crosses their path and sticks as an offense. They instead are together, do intimacy talk, get to know themselves. Gossip might not be the one of their strengths after all. So guys, these are the four confraternity in the love part right now. So I don't know which group you belong, but if you know you don't belong to any group, get yourself attached to one right now. Okay guys, the show is getting really serious now. The house has been divided into four different groups. We have Depressed Talker, Jekesh and Ayakrisa group, the Roxy and Obiebi group, the Roxy and Bola group, and then the Double Chris and Chivia group. It's getting very serious now and very hot. Yesterday, Jekesh and Bola almost had a fight, if not for the intervention of Auntie. And then today, there was a quarrel between Presh Talker and David Wilson. So the in-house quarrel. So the tension in the love part is becoming very intense. And don't forget, today is Friday, and they'll be having their Friday night party. We don't know whose ex is going to come again. So there'll be fire in the house. So if you've not been following the Ultimate Love Show, please stay tuned. Keep to your TV. Stay subscribed on all on Naija News and Entertainment. We'll bring you the gist as it's happening live from the Love Pad. Okay, if you're new, don't forget to subscribe and also hit on the bell icon to get new notifications when a story drops. Stay tuned.